The Sicarios are playing you. They want to use you against Sonny.
Johnny is a lot different than his dad.
Even if that's true, Anthony's the one pulling the strings. You're a lot smarter than this.
Okay, fine. You know, you and Dad don't want me to work with the Sicarios, right? I get that, and I'll accept it if you let me come and work for you instead.
Hi.
Hi.
How are you, sweetheart?
Good. How are you?
I'm good. Listen, I just came by before the girls. Just let me know if you think this is too much.
No, I'm feeling actually pretty good today.
Good. Glad to hear it.
Yeah, I had a pretty encouraging checkup from Dr. Lee. It looks like everything's on track. So this whole cheering up party really isn't necessary. It'll be nice to see my sisters, though.
Good, because they're very excited about having this little party soon. They wanted me to hire a dancing gorilla, but I said
what?
No. So you owe me, okay? But I am going to warn you about Molly.
Why is that?
She is, let's say, overly excited about the possibility of you having this baby and her becoming an aunt, so she is naturally reading up on babies and baby names. There's Madison, there's Miley.
I know. I'm sorry about that.
No, it's good she's excited. It's just she can be a little less than tactful, right, when she gets optimistic?
Sure. I mean, Molly has been very verbal about the possibility of Jason and I having a baby. She thinks that Jason and I can have a baby, I can heal his broken heart, and we can live happily ever after. Just like that.
You know how I feel. Your dad and I will never let you work with us.
Look, you're putting Jason in an impossible spot, Michael. Can't you at least admit you understand?
Yes, of course I understand, but it doesn't really help. Look, it's the same answer you've always given me, and guess what? You and Dad will never see me as anything but some helpless kid who always needs to be protected. You know what? And Johnny doesn't see me that way. He sees me as useful and competent, and he wants to train me.
You don't think there's a chance that they want to use you against Sonny? They're just saying what you want to hear, Michael.
No disrespect, Jason, but you're wrong. I already talked to Johnny about this. I let him know I would never go against you or Dad. And he got it.
You and Johnny already talked terms?
Yes. Look, he's given me an opportunity that you and Dad would never give me. And as long as I have his word that he'll keep the truce between him and Dad, then yes, Jason, I'm gonna work for him.
Yeah, so I've been busy with Jax, trying to help him navigate through this custody battle with Carly, and he's insistent on sole custody with Jocelyn, even though I think it's just not going to work out for him.
Well, going up against Carly doesn't really work out well for anyone.
I know, but he keeps shooting himself in the foot. He refuses to take my advice, and I mean, I understand what his issue is. I understand he doesn't want Jocelyn around Sonny and Jason because they're dangerous. I went through the same thing, and now I'm going to stop talking.
Yeah, Mom, I know your concerns about Jason and I having kids. I know that.
I have some concern about that, but more than that, I'm your mother and I want you to be happy. And if you want to have a baby with Jason, then I'm going to support that and I'm going to be happy for you. And I know that you and Jason will take a good long look at this and figure out if it's something you both really want to do.
I know, and that's what we're trying to do. I'm just not sure Jason exactly knows what is going to make him happy. He just lost Jake. This is all very weird, you know? I know he's not going to refuse or deny me if that's what I want.
Party time.
Yay.
Hi,
you. How are you? Where's your sister?
She had to handle something really quick, but she'll be here soon. Hi.
Hi.
I brought you some cupcakes.
Are these my favorite cupcakes? Oh, please tell me you got these.
Southern red velvet and some black and white.
Thank you. Well, that was very sweet. Do you think we could have one right now or should we wait for Chrissy?
No, dig in. I don't think she'll mind.
Actually, I think we should wait. I kind of wanted to talk to you about something before Christina gets here. Because she hates my names.
What names?
I've been doing some research for you on potential baby names.
Look, you know I respect you more than anyone. And I'm asking you to believe me when I tell you I would never let Johnny use me against you and Dad. Jason, I'm not some kid anymore. I need to live my own life. I need to make my own choices. I need to decide who to trust and what risks are worth taking.
I've said this to you before, and this will be the last time I say it. I think what you're doing is wrong. It's a mistake. You're gonna wind up hurting yourself and other people. It's not my place to control you, Michael. And no matter what happens, I still love you. You're right. You have to make your own choices. Even if I disagree. If you ever find yourself in trouble, don't think you can't come to me because you can't. I will never turn my back on you.
I got an idea. How about we eat the cupcakes now? And here you... Ooh, nice chocolate one for you. Yeah, go ahead, eat it. And you eat this one. Nice big piece right in there. And then if you're chewing, you can't talk.
Well, sure I can. I've got some really great names that I think you're gonna love.
I thought we weren't gonna pressure her about the names or the baby that she hasn't even had yet.
Well, this isn't pressure.
No?
This is more like a hypothetical exercise.
I warned you.
Mm-hmm. Relax. It'll be fun. And Sam doesn't mind, right?
No, not at all.
So, everybody has names that they like. Maybe from a favorite book or a favorite movie or some famous celebrity. Although I think that last one's kind of shallow.
Yeah, me too.
Anyways, I came up with my top three. Okay. Let me know what you think.
Let's hear it.
For boys, I like Caspian, Heathcliff, and Elijah.
Wow.
And then for girls, I came up with Meredith, Madison, and Riley.
Yep, they are all beautiful names.
How about you take those names and you write a nice little story about them?
That's actually a really good idea, because then you can use all the names and you don't have to give them to me to use.
Fine, you don't want to talk about the names, I get it.
Bingo!
Not five, okay?
You're not?
No.
Oh, well, I'm surprised. I thought you just said her.
That's funny, okay? Oh, she's really much older than
wow.
That. There she is.
Yeah, I get it. Hold on.
Chrissy!
Hey!
Hi! How are you?
Hi, how are you?
You look,
Hi!
What?
Good.
What on earth are you wearing?
You didn't tell me Mom was going to be here.
So you wanted to hide this new look from me? Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
Can we not do this right now? Tonight is supposed to be about Sam. We're trying to cheer her up, remember?
You don't mind if it's
not
about you,
right?
Let's make this about you just for a second. You weren't wearing that when you left this morning.
I changed. After school.
Yeah.
I'm trying out a new look, and I happen to really like it.
Well, it's a new look, all right. It's just maybe a little, hoochie mama for you, I think.
I don't. I'm almost 19. This is how girls my age dress. These are designer clothes, Mom. I had help picking them out from someone who knows about fashion.
Oh. Was this person a female or a male?
It's Maxie Jones, okay? She works for Crimson. I think she knows what she's doing.
I think she looks great. Well, I'm sorry, Mom, but you have to admit it's kind of cool. I mean, Maxie works in high fashion. She helps define what the world considers glamorous.
Does she? Because I thought she fetched lattes and answered the phone for Kate Howard. She is also much older than you are.
She's not that much older. I'm about to graduate high school and go into college.
Personally, I think you look very mature.
The dress is too short, your heels are too high, and your bra is showing.
The heels aren't any higher than the ones that Sam wears.
Hey.
Right?
Whoa. I'm staying out of this one.
Oh,
Come on, Sam, just be honest. What do you think of my new look?
Well, I think that everyone has their own style, and it's certainly a work in progress, but as you get older, you'll come into your own. I promise you that. Want a cupcake?
Oh, my life is evolving right now. I'm about to graduate high school and go into college, and dressing like this reflects who I am now.
If you were 10 years older and in Vegas, I'm not saying that you don't look beautiful in it. You look beautiful in anything that you wear. I'm saying it's just inappropriate. It's too old for you.
Well, I think she kind of looks like one of the Kardashian sisters.
Molly.
Or Selena Gomez. Maybe you could steal Justin Bieber.
Yeah, that's enough. Come on. Come over here.
Okay, the point is, I'm old enough to decide what I wear, and I like this.
Really? Okay, well, I pay for the dress, and your room and board, and your car, and your gas, and the college you're running off to, and I say I don't like it.
Hey, Jason, your timing is perfect. Now we can get a guy's opinion. What do you think of Christina's new look?
I didn't mean to bother you guys. I could come back.
Oh, please don't. No, this is actually perfect timing. They were all gonna leave, like, any second. They came over to bring me cupcakes and have a party and make me happy. I'm happy. It's time to go.
All right. Yeah. Sorry. Time to go, girls. Let's go. I'm sorry. Fun party,
bye.
Everyone.
Bye.
Enjoy it.
Bye.
Goodbye.
Okay. You can change in the car, okay? And then I'm gonna take it and I'm gonna burn it. Or I'll give it to Kim Kardashian.
She's
She'll look great in it.
Okay. That's good.
I'm sorry I didn't mean to break up your party.
No, thank you for breaking up the party. What happened? What's going on?
I think I might have lost Michael.
Well, what happened with Michael? Is that why you were this whole time?
No, I was actually talking to Michael at Abby's, and then on the way home, I stopped at Kelly's to grab us some dinner, and I ran into Elizabeth.
How's she holding up?
You know, she misses Jake, and she feels guilty, and it just got me thinking. If the only way to protect somebody you love is to give them up, is it worth it?
Jason, I don't think there's any easy answer to that question. I mean, how's Michael?
He said, good. Abby's been cleared of everything. They found the woman that Auntie hired to impersonate her.
Are you kidding? That's great.
No, it's great. Right? I know, but Auntie's been pulling the strings the whole time. Michael still wants to work for Johnny. And I don't know what to do. I don't know how to stop him. I mean, I could stop him if I made some people go away, but I don't think that's the way to handle things because Michael sees Johnny as a friend. If I take Johnny out, I run the risk of Michael turning against me.
Okay, so you're trying to figure out if it's worth losing Michael to save him.